uniting, a day of celebration, a day of rejoicing. I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready to go where he is. There's a far greater place. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. Listen to me. I remember Linda Gibson Johnson. She penned the words that is so fitting today. Here's what she said in the lyrics of the song. It said, between the pages of an old family Bible, I found dates of births, deaths, and some old revivals. I came upon a page, and it was written by a feeble hand. It said, this is my last request, and these are my funeral plans. It says, when I die, let me die speaking in other tongues. Let it ring in my ears, all of the songs that I have sung. Lord, give me the strength to praise you and to speak your name one more time. Then let your angels come down from glory and carry me to the other side. Now you go and tell my family and tell my friends not to weep for me. I'm going to live forever. I finally have been set free. Tell them not to mourn or to miss me, for when I'm gone, they can go and shout all around my graveside, for this is not my final home. Hallelujah. 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 Glory, glory, glory. This world is not our home. We're just passing through, pilgrims on a journey. But some glad morning, hallelujah, when the Lord comes, when he's ushered in on the wings of the morning, hallelujah, and the sounds of glory is resounding from ark to ark and all through heaven. You're talking about a break in the morning, a glorious celebration, and a coronation, hallelujah, on the streets of that city. Hallelujah. I don't want to end.
Hallelujah.
I'd love to preach a little bit more with him. Then hear him sing those songs, it must be the blood. Hear him to say, as I've heard him say many times before, it will be worth it all. Someday it will be worth it all. As a young boy, he took this, I guess Elsie was about a gallon of oil, and so many ministries have started from in birth through his ministry, being around my father, who preached for 50 years, and Brother Dallas Alexander, and around Reverend CBLs, and how they embraced me. But Brother Dan took an oil, about a gallon of it. I just bought a brand new suit that day, me and his cousin Brother Kenny Ellis, me and him traveled together. And I lived up in Kokomo, Indiana for 2 years with Brother Dan's uncle and Aunt Hiram and Georgie Ellis. And I lived there with Kenny, and we traveled all over and preached. But one night in revival at Purdom Street in Kokomo, Indiana, Dan and Elsie were there in revival. And Dan calls me out, and I wanted to look good. You know, I hadn't seen Dan and Elsie for a little time, and they came there, and I wore my new suit, and it just so happened that Dan was preaching on Psalms 92 and verse 10, where he says, I shall be anointed of fresh oil. And he happened to call me out. And I stood before him and I thought to myself, it didn't take a rocket scientist to figure out, I have a pretty good idea what he's about ready to do. And Lord, please don't let him pour it on my new suit. He didn't care. But he took that oil and he said, God is going to use you greater ministry. And you're going to go preaching and do things and exploits for God. And then he takes that gallon of oil